My name is Dr. Thomas Osborne. I'm a physician. I'm a director for the National Center of Collaborative Healthcare Innovation. What we're aiming to do is to provide the best, most advanced healthcare possible for our veterans. What we're trying to do is effectively solve problems that people want addressed and do it as efficiently as possible. And sometimes technology is the best way to do that. And the idea to some degree is to be an incubator of new tools and technologies and put VA in the driver's seat. So we're creating customized solutions for our veterans and not just being a recipient, we're proactively creating solutions that are customized for our needs. And perhaps because we're the largest integrated healthcare system in the United States, a secondary goal is we serve our citizens as a whole because the things that we do for our veterans are likely to also benefit the rest of the country.
Veterans understand veterans. It's like a close-knit community in a way. I work, you know, private sector, different jobs, all within IT field, and people that were not in service, that they think a little bit differently. We understand each other. It's on a different level. And it's a fulfilling job. For me, it's very important to do something that actually matters. You get that warm and fuzzy feeling inside that you're actually doing something of need and that potentially can help somebody. Working on AR, VR to kind of help with pre-surgical planning, to help with, in the future, actually performing surgery so the doctor can clearly see what they're doing.
Another really exciting component of this is we can take someone's own self-image in three dimensions and have a special camera system that's able to do that. And we can transport that three-dimensional, real-lifetime image of you and put it next to someone on the other side of the country real time. So if you think about like Star Wars, right? Princess Leia was being projected, you know, Obi-Wan, you're the only one that can help. We have the ability to do that now. We've done it in the lab. And so we're just trying to figure out the best way to implement this into care. So this is like cutting edge, bleeding edge stuff that we're doing at VA that's far in advance of so many others. So we're really excited about that. And we also have other things like a telepresence robot that Jocelyn is doing great work at our VA about.
I'm Jocelyn Reyes, Peg Salingan. I am a supervisor of recreation therapy here at VA Palo Alto Healthcare Center. When COVID was at its height, we had an outbreak. All the residents were quarantined. That meant that they have to remain in the room. The only staff who had the opportunity to go onto the units were the nurses and the doctors. The therapists, social workers, psychologists, they weren't allowed on that unit during that sensitive period of time. I was inspired because I saw this device called the Telepresence Robot in two sitcom television shows. So for example, like The Big Bang Theory or Modern Family. Through this device, you don't have to be physically present to engage with someone. You can use this device to travel and somewhat substitute your body, but the engagement and the communication, the face-to-face is still there.
They can still have that very human interaction and then go to those group sessions that they couldn't go to otherwise because either they're on isolation or they're not feeling well that day. They can have that very human interaction instead of being isolated. At the VA, we have an opportunity because it's so big. And we also have a responsibility to do this. We have a responsibility for our veterans who deserve this, who sacrificed their lives oftentimes and to put things aside and to fight for our country, for our privileged position that we have now. But quite frankly, our society needs it. And so the idea that we can do this at VA and address these problems for people who deserve it exponentially, and then use that same sort of tools and techniques and strategies and learnings to then help the rest of the society. That's really exciting. To have far-reaching positive impacts that would not only help the rest of the country, but perhaps the world.